Welcome to the celebration, St. Rose celebration of the seventh Sunday of Easter. Our opening hymn is Alleluia, Sing to Jesus.
Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace and the peace of God, the love of Jesus Christ, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to our sacred Eucharist at the table of the Lord. Here we celebrate, holding all of you fondly in our hearts. We're beginning to miss you more and more, and we're so happy and grateful for those helping us to be here and be present to you in your own home. So as we begin our sacred liturgy, let's remember God's goodness again and again in forgiving all of our sins. And let's call to mind our need for pardon of sins and for peace. Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God, the Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all of our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
God in the highest, and
Graciously hear our call, O Lord, so that we who believe that the Savior of the human race is with you in your glory, that we may experience as Jesus promised until the end of the world his abiding presence among us, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After Jesus had been taken up to heaven, the apostles returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey away. When they entered the city, they went to the upper room where they were staying. Peter and John and James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James, son of Alphaeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas, son of James. All these devoted themselves with one accord to prayer, together with some women, and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and his brothers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Exultantly. If you are insulted for the name of Christ, blessed are you, for the Spirit of glory and of God rests upon you. But let no one among you be made to thief, an evildoer, or as an intriguer. But whoever is made to suffer as a Christian should not be ashamed, but glorify God because of his name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Once again, good day to all of you, and thank you for joining us, all those who are at home. Thank you for praying with us on this wonderful Memorial Day weekend. Memorial Day, our world here in America will pause to remember all those who have given so much to our wonderful country in difficult and terrible times, perhaps even comparable to the present murderous pandemic. It will be a difficult holiday here in America because we have to be so careful about distancing from one another and celebrating too much. But we see already around our country that our people are being safe, that they are very careful. They were doing their best to wear their masks, to wash their hands, and and to put up with all that is required. Our children are very good, and right from the get-go today, I want to almost say congratulations, but it's like pre-congratulations, not just yet. Our First Communion kids have a little more time, and I know you're excited. I saw one of you last night in the parking lot, your mom and dad, you were helping in the garden. And we talked a little bit about your First Communion, which will be a beautiful event. And so we want you to really join with your mom and dad, though, in preparing those lessons that Mrs. McGoldrick sent to you, so that you learn as much as you can about Jesus before your day comes. That's so important. The more you know about Jesus, of course, the more you know, the more there is to love. I am reminded today of a sad story of someone that I met in the hospital. Their daughter had a small, actually it was a bicycle accident. It didn't seem very serious, but her daughter had several problems resulting from crashing into another bicycle. Her mom is a good Christian Catholic and began to pray for her daughter Barbara. And 1 month led into the next, and Barbara had multiple injuries and multiple internal injuries. One day she just couldn't sleep at all. She was so sick. The next day she had sores where she broke some bones in her leg. Her mother just kept praying. Her mother was young, and her prayers were based on results, on causes, on miracles, on getting better safely. But the prayers didn't seem to bring many results, but no miracles that mom expected. But she was still free of high expectation from her prayer. And in a hope, her prayer gradually began to be turned into unseen experiences in her own life. The mother, as she prayed for her daughter, promising that she could never give up on her daughter. But her daughter still had multiple illnesses. She discovered that hope, when you pray, it's not for magic, some magical experience. It's not even for some miracle. Hope is to ground us, and to ground that woman in her faith. As St. Julian says, a good prayer for the pandemic, a very good prayer, is this: all will be well, all will be well. All manner of things will be well. If that's too long for you, just say the first two lines. All will be well, all will be well. That prayer, in my experience, has saved so many mothers and fathers over grief for their sons and daughters, for sickness and death, or just for ordinary troubles of life. And it's good for us to think of that right now. And that's why Jesus, in his readings, these beautiful readings, naming his disciples, naming those who are going to follow him. The gospel is the Last Supper scene. It's the Last Supper scene. Jesus is great things are about to happen. Jesus is returning to his Father in heaven. After those 33 years, the last three, which was of his mission, to open heaven to all people through his death on the and then the resurrection, his death on the cross. The woman wrote a story about her prayers, that hope is robust and muscular, that hope can be long-suffering, that it can be sometimes vicious, that the world's most evil places, think of New York City of today, and the hope that is there, in all the tragedy and all the loss. We're going to pray for Megan McCann today on our holiday, who used to be an altar server at St. Rose of Lima Church, probably would still like to be one. Megan is a young nurse right downtown New York City, where she tells her mom and dad she loves her work. Like all good nurses, she's dedicated, committed, and would not be anywhere else in the world. Her mother, like the mother of the young bicyclist, prays for her every day, and so do we. Hope meets a hard promise. Hope calls us to kneel on difficult floors, on rocks and gardens. One of my first experiences of like sort of adult prayer was when my father was in an accident, and he was very seriously hurt in the accident. He was in the hospital in those days for a long time. And my mother would line up her six kids, and we had to take a bus to the hospital. And every time we went to the hospital, I would silently be praying that we could go up and see my father first. But my mother always said, no, we're going to the chapel first, and we're going to pray. And then I started hoping. I didn't know much about the rosary when I was 14, but I hope, no, don't tell me she's going to pull out the rosary, because then we're going to be in the chapel for a long time, and I'd rather go see my mom. But my mother taught me those things over many different years, and I'd say she went to the right place. She went where hope is encouraged, and hope is given because of our relationship with God. And that's what's going on in the readings today. Jesus is looking at the disciples, and he knows they're finally ready to pray. Remember that all through his stories, whenever he went up to pray, they waited down at the bottom of the hill. They didn't even want to walk up the hill. But then, what did they do? They began asking Jesus, Lord, teach us how to pray. And they did it just in the crisp of time, because Jesus was about to ascend to his Father in heaven. But I'm sure he would never have left them unable to pray and communicate with not only Jesus' Father, but with our Father, with our Father. The woman in this story learned throughout hard battles that prayer is not always simple or easy, and that prayer changes. And her comfort today is in being with her sick child and praying with her as often as they are together. For our invitation from God, you know, at the Last Supper, he said, it is nearly over. And he was telling them how much he loved them and giving them the ability to carry on his work of saving. Today I'd like to thank people in Ireland and from my own family in New Jersey and for the Flynn kids, that they may all be well. Let us pray. Lord, open our hearts. Give us the grace to trust in your care and in your love. Despite all the obstacles we see, help us to place our cares in your loving hands.
For the church, that the people of God sent into the world to bear witness may take heart as we share Christ's sufferings, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world, that worldly powers may be challenged to work for justice and peace, by the presence and witness of Christ's disciples in the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the men and women in the armed services who have died in the defense of our nation and paid the ultimate sacrifice for the freedoms we hold so dear, that God's glory will shine upon them and that they may share in the peace of the heavenly kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are struggling economically, that God will calm their fears, guide them to resources that will sustain them, and help them to be open to others who wish to support them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful departed, especially Barbara Shanley, who died last week, and all the deceased of the parish, may they be raised up on the last day to live forever. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, we ask that you hear all of these prayers, as well as the prayers of our heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn, I Have Loved You.
Sacrifice will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
And the Son of God, sacrifice is your name, to the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all this holy church.
Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful people with our sacrifice and offering, that through these acts of devotion we may pass over to the glory of heaven through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to praise you more gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed. An integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with Easter joy, every land, every nation, every people exalts in your praise, and even the saints in heaven together sing that unending hymn of glory.
Oh,
indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper had ended, he took the cup filled with wine. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the cup to his friends and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, that will be shed for you and for the many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of Jesus' death and resurrection, we offer you the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Robert our Bishop and all the clergy and the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember also, Lord, our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Joseph, her husband, blessed apostles and saints, with Saint Rose of Lima, and all those people who have pleased you throughout the ages, may we all merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every kind of evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the light of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus, you said to your friends, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. And
let us offer one another some sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Jesus, who comes to take away the sin of the world. May you share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Communion hymn, At That First Eucharist.
This are you, Eucharist.
Hear us, O God, our Savior, and grant us confidence that through the sacred mysteries there will be accomplished in the body of the whole church what has already come to pass in Christ himself, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
I want to announce to everyone that St. Rose of Lima will open for Masses on Pentecost Sunday, which is a week from next Sunday. We are looking for lots of volunteers who want to help us reopen the church after 10 or 11 weeks. If you would like to help on that team, straighten out the church after each Mass, we ask that you just call the rectory this week and give your name, and someone will get back to you about a meeting early next week. So we'd ask that you call as soon as possible. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go now and bring Jesus and his love and light into our darkened world.
Thanks be to God.
And as we go forth, let us celebrate this Memorial Day for tomorrow by singing America the Beautiful, especially remembering all those who have given their lives for our country.